Hello, beta testers. You know how Insomniac Spider-Man is a love letter to gaming and Spider-Man as a character? Well, Marvel's Avengers Spider-Man is like a manifesto found smeared on a wall in blood by a studio obviously proud of their serial killer status. Their preferred victim? Why, beauty itself, in all its forms, in the face of devastatingly vocal gamers and fans, Crystal Dynamics planted itself by the river of ugly and said, "No, you drown." Also, even though we haven't patched our buggy game, pay me money for these ugly skins. You see the problem? So viewer, maybe you have three questions. Just like and subscribe right now, cause I'm about to answer them. How does he swing? If you came here looking for ring-a-ding-ding, I'm afraid this Spider-Man does not swing, which is ridiculous because...
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, that you're rolling around in your gray stand. All his webs look the same. These animations are such a shame. Look out, here's Budget Spider-Man.
No. Global warming. No, Global Warming! We didn't listen. Low fucking resolution JPEGs for roofs. Fuck.
Stiff, clunky, unresponsive, exactly the kind of just below average mediocrity that'll situate Marvel's most beloved character right into the forgettable territory that is Crystal Dynamics, Marvel's Avengers. Remember how the internet reacted to the footage that the developers provided to IGN? They were right on the money. And from the bottom of my heart, thank you to the consumers intelligent enough to discern that this is not only unworthy of your money and time, but not something to be supported so that we don't see a future where launches like this are the norm. But allow me to be clear, this is not a launch. This is over 450 days after the game came out. Battlefield and Call of Duty, as terrible a shape as they're in, they can both claim to have just come out. Marvel's Avengers, over 450 days away from launch after two betas, still performs like trash after they unceremoniously just dumped Spider-Man in there with no story missions or villains to fight. All the bugs you remember, they're still here, and some new ones are here to boot. Hooray! I would list them, but it's kind of like the same bugs that I've been listing for over a year, so I trust in your special eyes.
The high priority target isn't spawning.
Nope.
What the fuck was that guy doing? What the fuck?
When you can't pick up loot in a looter, that's Marvel's Avengers. When you can't access the loot locker without freezing in a looter, that's Marvel's Avengers. Your entire ass save progress being wiped, sometimes at the completion of the raid, that's Numberwang. It's okay though, the loot's still trash. My personal favorite though is the game's most recent update robbed players of units and fragments. I lost over 850,000 units. They did this at the same coincidental time that they patched in their new RNG shipment system, where you could actually have used those units on something in-game. But it's okay, I'm sure they'll patch in a way for you to buy units soon. Oops. You know, this identical problem happened over a year ago, back when the community team at the very least pretended to do their job. So here's what Megan Marie of the community team said at the time over a year ago when this happened the first time.
Oh no, a bummer to see that backup saves didn't work. I'm still pushing the team to look into this one. We are investigating if there is a good way to grant individual users units while we hunt down the bug.
Please don't share this info, as people could contact us and exploit it. I'll update you as I have more details.
After multiple messages and justified frustration over the time this and many other users have lost, they press the issue in a civil way. They ask, "Any update on the unit situation? It seems like it's starting to blow up on the forums. I was not very happy with my data being lost as well, but I played and I grinded until I reached farmable missions to
only have a stealth patch the farm that I was doing.
I think you get the picture, guys.
Crystal Dynamics Megan Marie responds, "We've been digging into this. I just got permission to post the following, and for your knowledge, we are looking at how to grant anyone who contacts us the missing units. You gotta contact them for what they took from you, bitch."
Because Crystal Game Broke and they find it funny, all up until it's like the cost of money. Crystal Game Broke and they find it funny, all up until it's like the cost of money.
Yeah, so this identical problem that happened literally over an entire ass year ago,
it happened again.
So shout out to Paul Tass, who delicately avoids reporting things like this, but has the nerve to say shit about my coverage. Biatchnyaga? Yeah, what's crazy though is this blunt coverage is inexplicably okay when it comes to games like GTA, Call of Duty, Battlefield, Cyberpunk, Anthem, Outriders, even Halo, you name it.
But with Little Marvel's Avengers,
some sort of niche game made by college students who were wearing blindfolds as like some sort of challenge, it's not okay. Hopefully in the future, these dog water guzzling illiterates will shut their fucking mouth instead of confidently hurling ignorance at someone who's more informed than them. I'm not a soothsayer. I have a crystal ball that can tell me the future. This is a pattern, habitual missteps out of something that we should set our watches to and expect to keep disappointing. Progress wipes, erased saves, and stolen units are literally everything on my update oopsie bingo card, and it happened again. This Spider-Man is so clunky and unresponsive that you'll end up dodging around enemies instead of the game actually registering the takedown input. This Spider-Man, in a sentence, is like an elaborate advertising campaign for Insomniac Spider-Man, who, again, we have to be so thankful for them having. I thank each and every one of you who likes, subscribes, comments, or sends in your videos via Twitter, Discord, PlayStation, YouTube, wherever. Thank you for helping to counter this trend of unfinished garbage extending its hand for money. What sucks is this is Spider-Man, so it's gonna get that money from people who never go online or search up any, you know, media or content on any of the things that they just see on a shelf or they see on sale and they just cop it. And to company, that's the dream consumer. Somebody who's gonna log in once or twice after buying it, buy a couple of skins, and who cares what they do after that. But if what you do after is make your voice heard, because what you paid for isn't what you get, by helping people vote with their wallets, you are the instrument of change. You paid for this game, and you're allowed to critique it within civil parameters. Don't allow people to redefine the boundaries of what you can and can't say by calling everything that they don't like toxic or negative. When the difference between accurate and inspired has to be taught in this community, it's clear these people don't know dictionary definitions of anything. Crystal Dynamics, you owe people their units and their time back. The suggestion is you throw people enough credits to at least buy one of your pricey MCU skins like you did back when you at least pretended to care about public reception. How does Spider-Man look? Bad. Can you believe it? How does he feel? Bumpy. Leave a comment and I'll respond to all of them. That's my gift to you. My wish list is in the description. Merry Christmas, beta testers. I'm sorry.